Tonight I wanna see the bright lights over me. Show me something magical, something beautiful. Come and take me higher, set my world on fire tonight. Tonight, show me everything I want and more. You take me right around the world. I feel it tonight, got me feeling so right. Yes, I'm a good life.
This week on Top Billing, Stormers and Springbok center Damien de Allende sees the gap and takes it. 400-meter world champion Wayde for Niekerk's only Achilles heel is his shoe collection. Rocking in Heels founder Takis Maswanganye and fitness expert Tori Alexandra put the latest activewear through its paces. Our first black test centurion, Temba Bavuma, shows he needs no second invitation to the highest form of the game. Impossible is nothing for teenage surf revelation, KZN's Sam Cele. Miss SA, Liesl Laurie, joins renowned chef Matt Manning as he makes apples the star of his one-ingredient cooking revolution. And your presenter this evening is Lorna Maseko, bringing you the show from the home of the Gounder family. Starting as their dream when they lived in a one-bed apartment, it's a testament to their hard work and a tribute to the good life.
Good evening and a rousing welcome to Top Billing as we celebrate a new generation of extraordinary South Africans, starting with Springbok heartthrob Damien de Allende, who already looks set to become one of the greats.
Damien stepped into the breach just as the Springbok midfield was losing the services of captain and fellow centre Jean de Villiers. With an eye for a gap, a terrific handoff and speed, he plays with such confidence, it's hard to believe that just 5 years ago, he was a scholar at Cape Town's Milnerton High.
This is where your rugby career started. What is it like to be back?
No, it's pretty special. It's nice to come back to a place where you made a lot of memories. And it's nice to come support the kids as well. They really take a lot of it and they really appreciate it. So it's quite nice to be back here.
Headmaster Paul Bessner knew there was something special about Damien. A fun-loving learner and natural athlete who excelled not just at rugby, but at every sport he tried.
Hello, sir.
Hello, David. Still calls me sir, after all these years.
You must be so proud of how far Damien's come.
We're so proud of him as a school, and the PRO that he's done has been absolutely fantastic. I'm not sure if everybody knows, but there were many schools that tried to get Damien to leave. He was offered bursaries and he was offered scholarships, but he's a typical Milnerton boy, loyal to the community and to the school, and so he stayed. And we're very proud of him, very much so.
Integrity goes a long way. I heard Damien was quite the troublemaker growing up.
He was always playing jokes and having fun, and I recall on one occasion during some matric dress-up, he came in a massive gorilla suit and ran up and down the corridors and terrorized the teachers for the day. But of course that was Damien, and everybody loved him for that. I think it was good fun.
He's a professional rugby player. His name has to be on a board somewhere.
Jade, if you ever look behind me up here, you'll see his name's up twice. Once for cricket. Not many people know that he actually got into the provincial team first for cricket when he was in grade 10 or 11, and eventually the rugby came.
So you're quite a latecomer to rugby.
I only started playing rugby in high school. I played soccer and cricket at Milnerton Primary. I only started really taking rugby seriously when I got to grade 10.
The school's rugby field will always be special to him. It's where he learned to love the game and scored his first winning try.
What was it like coaching Damien?
Oh, it was nice coaching him. He was an easy guy to coach. He was always very committed, trained hard, was very focused, always wanted to be first when we did speed runs and stuff. But I think that's part of his character, you know, hard working. And I think at the early stage, he knew exactly what he wanted. As I predicted when he was about 19, I said, at 23, he'll make Springboks. He made it actually at 22, but he turned 23 on tour. And I think he has got a bright future in the game.
Damien, would you say that Heinrich is one of the reasons why you are where you are today?
Yeah, Mr. Martin taught me a lot coming through rugby. He first made me actually believe when I was 16 years old that I could make a career out of it. And that gave me a lot of confidence. So yeah, he has taught me a lot. I still visit him every now and again at the school, and we still talk and he still gives me advice. And yeah, he's also come from a rough background, so, and he's also got quite a numerous achievements in rugby as well. So it's quite nice to have someone like him to look up to, and someone like him helping me in my career as well.
If you could go back and tell your 16-year-old self something, what would it be?
Sure, that would actually be quite difficult. Not anything rugby related, but more school related. I think I would have tried to study a bit harder. I did put rugby before anything else and I'll never regret that. Oh. But yeah, if there's one thing I could go back and change, it's probably to go study a bit harder than what I actually tried.
His Western Province practice sessions are an important commitment, and his teammates love his positive energy.
If you hear the name Damien de Allende, there's always like a little chuckle, because every single morning being at training, you'll always expect something from Damien, if it's a loud shout, if it's a loud song, but he will always entertain you, lighten up your days. Even in the huddle, there's always something you will do out of the ordinary, but he always bring a laugh and he always bring a positive vibe to the team. Into your face.
There's another sport that Damien excels in, the gentlemanly game of golf, which he enjoys with his close friends.
Damien tells me you guys go way back.
It has been a while. It's been preschool, primary school, high school. Him and I know each other for 18, close to 20 years now. He's a big character, a standout character. He's been that way since primary school, high school. Always had that little naughty streak in him, and it's good to see that on the field. He gets into a little bit of a niggle, but you know, he's always the gentle one off the field, especially his close, loyal friends. He stays humble, stays big, gentle character, and it's good to always see that.
And then you wiggle your bum up.
For real?
No, I'm just trying to get daughter.
What Damien enjoys about golf is practicing the focus and concentration that's also so important in scoring in Super Rugby.
What would you say is the recipe for your team's success?
In the beginning of the year, we always set our team goals and what we want to achieve throughout the year. Yeah, we've achieved some of our goals that we set out as a team. And we still got quite a few youngsters in the team, me included, which is quite nice because it keeps a lot of the older guys hungry, keeps them, a lot of them in their place as well. And hopefully we can carry on improving as a team.
But it's impossible to ignore Damien's looks. Being Mr. January in the 2016 Cosmo Sexiest Man Canada makes it 2 years in a row he's got this level of attention.
I saw you nominated for You Spectacular Sexiest Man of the Year. What was that like?
Yeah, obviously it's a nice achievement, but yeah, I'm not really fazed about stuff like that. I get quite shy in front of the camera.
Well, you might be shy, but the camera loves you.
I hope so.
Back from club rugby in Japan, Damien's getting over an ankle injury. Hopefully in time to join the Stormers' new attack-minded game plan.
Damien, it's been so incredible getting to know you a bit better and play golf with you. But before I go, there is one thing I just have to do. I've been watching Jeannie D feel the abs of many rugby players over the years, and my hands are all warmed up now, so I'm ready to touch, pause, and engage.
Guys are all into rugby already, but if your plan is to get more girls in the stands, pick that man.
Coming up, Wayde for Niekerk's a shoo-in for gold at the Rio Olympics. Plus, high-performance gear meets ready-to-wear.
I'm Pharrell Williams. Willis and I collaborating to raise 100 million rand for better education in South Africa through the My School program. Together, we're going to make a difference. Are you with us?
For the fashion-conscious athlete, gold is the must-have accessory for 2016. With the Rio Olympics on the horizon, let's catch up with someone right in the running, world 400-meter champion Wayde van Niekerk.
Born in Cape Town, Wayde finished his schooling here at Grey College in Bloemfontein. The football-crazy kid and fan of Kaizer Chiefs, Liverpool and Real Madrid has grown into a champion track athlete. Now the city of his birth and the city of roses both lay claim to this modest young superstar.
Don't be fooled by this man's silky smooth soccer skills. He is in fact at the moment the fastest man in the world over 400 meters. Wayde, brother, what's it like being back at your school where it all began for you?
No, thank you for having me. It's really been a blessing, especially knowing how they've been supporting me over this last few seasons.
And this is obviously how you like to get away from it all, take your mind off things.
Yeah, this is the way I relax and get the family together, the friends together. We just try and have fun and take my mind away from athletics, because I know once the season starts, it's 100% athletics.
Wayde moved to the Free State with his mother, Odessa Swartz, when he was 13. Currently a scholarship student at the University of the Free State, he chooses to live with his family, including four siblings. On the day he became world champion, everyone, including his girlfriend, Chesney Campbell, was at home watching.
So this time you're not on the TV, you're in the room where the magic happened, where everybody here witnessed the race. Take us through, bit by bit, from the moment you lined up at the start, what you were going through, what was going through your mind?
Yeah, personally for myself, I knew that the target men was lane 5 and lane 8, which was Kirani James and LaShawn Merritt. When it came to the race, I knew within this first 100 meters, it was the moment that's going to make the race for myself. And I knew the closer I can catch up with lane 8, which was LaShawn Merritt, I knew that that's the man that I need to use to start building up my momentum for the race itself. As I hit the last 200 meters, I could see the gold medal being mine, but at the same time, I knew I had two quite quality athletes right at the back of me.
Heading into that home straight, you're so far ahead of everybody else. Did you think something was wrong at that stage because you couldn't see anyone in your periphery?
I could. When I look back into the race itself, I see I tensed up quite a lot, but I knew at that moment I was thinking more of the gold medal than trying to keep calm. But at the same time, I'm just grateful for the fact that I could fight all the way to the finish line and knowing that it was mine once I crossed the finish line.
And you can see you literally gave it everything because at the end there you were finished, you collapsed.
Yeah, it seems like I'm really the only 400 meters athlete that knocks out after my 400 meter race. I watched the women's race, I think the day after mine, and I saw three ladies laying down on the floor. Then I said to myself, okay, no, it's cool. I'm not the only one.
Chesney, you've got video proof of the moment, which is going to be worth a lot of money.
Yes, Wayde asked me to take a video of everyone's reaction so he can see when he comes back. At the end of the day, you'll just see everyone move out of their seats to right in front of the TV, yelling and screaming and just going all out for Wayde.
Omar, I'm sure that you were shouting louder than everyone else.
It was so emotional day. Wherever I go watching Wayde, I just got that happy feeling every time. Yay, they can gaan win. Just wait, you will see. Wayde gonna win. And the moment he strike, I just got that happy feeling and say, Wayde did it.
The medals started coming once he literally stepped into his stepfather's shoes. Stephen Swartz gave Wayde his first pair of running shoes, and the 23-year-old champ will never forget it.
It's clear from this section of the house that you are very proud parents.
Yeah, we are. We've got a wall of memories, starting with a lot of firsts and then obviously ending up with the World Championship medal also being this wall here. So all our kids are actually displayed in terms of what they achieve, sport and academy.
Yeah, and I'm actually so happy because I kept his first pair of spikes ever, as well as his first Western Province vest.
Was it clear that this man was going to be a champion from a young age?
Wayde was always a fighter since birth, and we never could have envisaged that he will be the world champion. That fighting spirit that he started from day one, it's just continuing throughout, so we're so proud of Wayde.
Who's influenced you the most over the course of your career?
It's definitely my father. And the amazing role model that he's played for me as an athlete. It's really something special to me and something that I really cherish, the fact that he's not my birth father, but he accepted me. At least I believe he's my God-given father, and it's something that I really cherish, and it's really something that he's someone that I'll always admire.
Well, that gold medal is testament to the amazing work that your family's been doing, so can we have a little peek?
Yeah.
Cool. World champion, fastest man on the continent over 400 meters. What an achievement.
Yeah.
Stephen, well done.
Together with all his parents have done, it's a case of nature and nurture working in tandem.
Yeah, welcome to my room. This is where I chill, where my brother and I stay. This is where my friends and I and my brother all get together and watch movies or play games or whichever else.
So this is what the bedroom of a world champion looks like.
That's how my bedroom looks.
Now, I couldn't help but notice you've got a serious obsession with sneakers. I don't see any formal shoes, I don't see slops, I don't see anything else, just sneakers. Is that a correct observation or is it just coincidental?
Yeah, I'm a huge fan of collecting them. I love wearing them or whichever, I'd say, outfit I have for the day, I try and match them. So yeah, I'm really blessed to be able to collect them.
Cool. Are you ready to hit the track?
Cool. No problem.
I know you're unbeaten this year, but that's about to change, eh? How do you like my confidence? But you're size 9, right?
I am.
Oh, man, I can't even borrow a pair of your track shoes yet.
Only 0.3 of a second separates Wayde's best time from the world record. He's so close.
What advice would you give to all those up-and-coming youngsters that are wanting to follow in your footsteps one day and become a world champion?
Well, something that affects me quite a lot is the fact that these youngsters, they tend to give up quite quickly. I know personally that wherever you want to be, the journey is not easy at all. You need to go through struggles and you need to go through obstacles. So simply just don't give up in your dream. Anything is possible, so just try and push it through. I mean, I'm a young South African boy who never thought that I'd be up there with the world's best, and look today what I've achieved, and I'm just truly grateful and thankful that the Lord blessed me with this talent.
Okay, I'm feeling warm. You warm?
I'm ready.
You ready?
Let's do this.
We're not doing 400 meters though.
Ah, it's fine.
Not a chance.
Jonathan wasn't above giving himself a 1 second advantage, and it almost worked. Almost. No matter which way our editors cut it, it was Wayde's race.
You're just toying with me, brother.
Nice race.
Hey?
Nah, I'm tired.
You're not even breathing heavy, dude. That was 50 meters. You keep that pace up over 400 meters. How hard were you trying there? Scale of 1 to 10. Honestly, now?
Well, you had quite an impressive start. So you got me by surprise. I wouldn't tell the cameras what you actually did. But when it came to the last few meters, I just thought, let's try and make it an even race. So I had to dip you.
Yeah, you were going probably at 50%, so I was going 100. Yeah, respect. Respect.
What a motivation Wayde is. If you needed any more incentive to get active, then the latest collaborations between top designers and sports brands are chic and versatile. Bringing the trend to you are Woolworths.
It's fashion on the fly as designers like London-based Stella McCartney have partnered with Adidas, and New York's Cynthia Rowley has created a new line around fitness wear.
I generally go day by day with the look good, feel good mantra, and nothing makes you feel better than daily exercise and gorgeous fashion. So why not merge the two? Looking your best while working out is a modern day priority. So I'm here to chat to the experts to see if you can work out while you work it.
Joburg choreographer Takis Masvanganya is the founder of popular Rocking in Heels dance fitness classes.
I can imagine that in the dance world, looking your best really is priority.
I believe my image is a big part of my business card. And what I love the most is that my personal style and my dance style are very similar. They represent bold, edgy, fun, and strong.
So how do you merge the two?
I definitely take in consideration the functionality and the comfort of the clothing. And because I'm internationally trained, I love showing off with my extensions and just being flexible. And also I try avoid materials that are very uncomfortable.
But even when you're not rehearsing, you still pull off being in your active wear.
I'm able to wear it all day because it's super versatile. I can go in from a hectic rehearsal, I'm grabbing a coffee with friends, and it just breathes so easy and I feel so comfortable. And at the same time, I'm on trend.
You definitely do look on trend. Now I want to see how your active wear holds up in a Takis dance routine.
Watch and learn.
What do you think? Amazing. You are brilliant.
With recent innovations in fabric and construction, Cape Town-based blogger and personal trainer Tori Alexandra finds she can really live in these outfits. It's an evolutionary leap in activewear.
Hi Tori, how's it going?
Good.
Judging by our ensembles, it seems like the days of spandex and leotards and leg warmers are behind us.
Women are doing lots of different training, not just jazzercise or step aerobics. So we need our clothes to go with our lifestyle. A crop top is great for Pilates and yoga, but also you can run in it and it's going to be supportive and comfortable. As a personal trainer, I have to wear the same clothes throughout the day. So breathability is really important, moisture wicking, so it needs to dry, and comfort.
That's the inspiration behind the latest performance wear available at Country Road and Woolworths.
The variety and intensity of daily training has really changed.
Yeah, I'd say women are definitely more active these days, and it's throughout the day. You know, we like to incorporate an active lifestyle with a healthy lifestyle. Going for smoothies with the girls, you have to transition easily, and your activewear has to suit your life perfectly in that situation.
Well, as much as I've enjoyed hanging out here with you today, I need a smoothie.
Evolving along with active fashion, new recipes for high-performance smoothies are a blend of the best fuels that nature has to offer.
Now, I feel like we have all of the ingredients for looking good. Now, seems like we've got to put all the ingredients for feeling good together.
Yeah.
So you're going to be making us a smoothie.
I am. We're going to start with some frozen banana, which is good to give you like a nice texture that's almost like an ice cream sort of a vibe. And then throw some nuts in, almonds. And then we have a macadamia nut butter, which is the best if you've never had it.
Would you use that as a replacement for peanut butter?
Both of them have really good benefits. They've got a lot of protein in them. So it's just, this has a creamier texture than peanut butter. We're gonna throw some chia seeds in.
Oh, the miracle food.
Yes, it is a superfood. It's got omega-3s in it. It's got antioxidants, high protein, and high fiber. So that's always something that's good to throw in. And a little bit of coconut. And some unsweetened almond drink.
Be good?
It already smells so good.
Yes, and then we're just gonna pop the lid on and blend away.
It packs an all-natural punch that builds and re-energizes.
Here's to my new healthy lifestyle.
There you go, cheers.
For your leisure and your athletic lifestyle, this performance wear lets you live active, stay on trend, and it's waiting for you at Woolworths.
Sporty designer outfits you're happy to be seen in when you're out and about. Far less admin, and I love that.
Next up, Temba Bavuma gives the Proteas 100 reasons to smile. And Sam Cele is fast becoming SA Surfing's new sensation.
Bavuma was born months after Nelson Mandela was released from prison. If anyone symbolizes Utata Madiba's faith in the power of sport to unify, then it's our first black test batsman to hit a century.
Temba's 102 against England helped draw the second test at Newlands and should cement a place in the test side for this BizHub Highveld Lions vice-captain.
Take me back to when you started playing cricket.
I played cricket at a very young age. I mean, I grew up in Cape Town in Langa, and I think that's where everything started. I used to play, you know, in the streets. Luckily as well, all my uncles played cricket. So, you know, when I was a young guy, I got to watch them, and I think, yeah, that's where everything developed. I think it wasn't just cricket, it was just sport in general.
You've achieved so much in such a short space of time. What have been some of your highlights?
The biggest highlight for me was being selected, you know, to represent the Proteas in the test squad. I think, you know, it's what every, you know, cricketer, one, every young guy, you know, dreams of achieving.
So now, I've never played cricket before. I'm hoping that you'll teach me some things. Okay. I've been watching, so I realize I've got to go slow, slow, far, 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 far. And then like,
okay,
throw
one
the
thing,
ball?
One thing. I think because we're short,
okay.
I think us being batsmen is better suited. The guys who are tall will do the bowling. We
I'm
can do the batting.
I'm just worried about the ball hitting my face.
That's why you gotta use the bat in your hand.
Okay, but what if I don't see? You know,
no,
like.
No. You'll okay. see the ball.
Okay, so I'm not gonna bowl. Okay, so yeah. I'll bat. Okay, that's
so
fine.
So we'll focus on the batting.
Okay, cool. Should we go?
Okay, yeah.
Lorna was in good hands, as her coach has an unusually high rate of hitting 50s, then batting on to make centuries. It suggests a rare mental strength.
I definitely need one of these, right?
Definitely.
I'm gonna need your help, because obviously my hands are a bit.
Okay. There we go. Can you see out the.
Gosh, there is nothing cute about this outfit at all. At all. All right.
That's... I think the most simplest and easiest thing I can tell you is to try and watch the ball. That's the easiest thing I could say.
Just as long as you don't aim the ball at my face, you and I will still be friends after this.
Nah, I'll be aiming at the stumps, don't worry.
Fashion Week is so much simpler.
Are you ready? Remember, watch the ball. Your life depends on it.
Take it easy, buddy. I'm so scared. Yay! I did it, oh my gosh, I can't believe I hit it. I didn't think I was gonna hit it again.
Batting's about footwork, and as a dancer, Lorna got right into it.
That's what the cricketers do every time they hit the ball. Ah! That wasn't bad, right? Can I join the team? I think I could join the team.
Yeah, you might need a bit more days to practice, but
I could join the team.
There's something we can work with. There's something we can definitely work with.
That's what Temba's teachers thought when he arrived at St. David's Marist Inanda School. where his 15-year-old brother, Paula, is currently in grade 11.
Initially, when you came to the school, you were hoping to play soccer.
Yeah, when we moved up from Cape Town to Johannesburg, soccer was the biggest thing on my mind. You know, I mean, I'd heard of teams of obviously like Kaizer Chiefs, the London Pirates. So I was hoping, you know, in my own self that I'd get, you know, drafted into those kind of setups. But unfortunately, it didn't happen. You know, luckily, you know, when I came to the school, you know, cricket was something that was very strong. So that's how I got into cricket. And from there, you know, I developed and managed to get to where I am now.
Temba recently set up a coaching facility where not so long ago, Amarinda Binda was coaching him.
When Temba started playing cricket, did you realize his talent from a young age?
Yes, actually, I realized that Temba got a talent, but it was not about a talent only. Temba's plus point was his passion and his hard work. You see those nets. Temba didn't come only one or twice actually in a week. He came all 5 days, not for an hour, 2 or 3 days every day, hitting thousands of balls in the nets. That was the reason actually.
With him not being that tall, it's taken fortitude to crack the national squad. And this is how he tunes out.
So welcome in.
I didn't know you had a little special skill, Mr. DJ.
I wouldn't call it a skill. It's just something I do in my free time. You know, you need this as a cricketer. You're always traveling. It's more like a hobby, you know, something I try to do just to unwind. You know what I mean? Especially with us cricketers, it gets busy. It's always nice to just have something where you can almost get lost in.
I'd love to hear you play. What are you doing there?
So here you're killing the other song. This is the volume.
Okay.
So you almost want to kill the other song and let the one song play on this side. So right, the song is playing, it's on this side.
Right.
So then the song plays there.
So you don't do all of this stuff?
I think because with house music it's a bit more smoother.
Right.
You don't really have to do much with the thing. You almost just let the song play. But if you're playing with hip-hop, that's when the guys do all the funny things.
What do you mean the funny things?
Like the effects, they play around with the effects. So these are like effects.
Right.
So listen. So you almost hear the...
Okay.
Those, yeah. So these are all...
As yet unknown to audiences for his DJing, in cricket, his colleagues are his biggest fans.
I've noticed quite a few awards. Please tell me a bit about them.
These are my most recent awards that I got from the Bizarre Highport Lions. I think my most special one would definitely be this one. This is the Players Player of the Year.
Nice.
Yeah, I think it means quite a lot, you know, when the guys, you know, vote for you, you know, as being someone who contributed significantly towards the team. So yeah, this is the one that I hold close to my heart.
I believe you're quite the academic and your parents enforced that on you.
I think one thing my parents did do, you know, especially my dad, you know, was drive the significance of education. After I was done with school, you know, he made sure I went to varsity. And luckily, you know, I was able to get, you know, that BCom in financial management qualification.
Nice.
You know, and I just think the biggest thing was just to try find a balance, you know, between your sport and also, you know, Temba the person.
Temba Bavuma has ambition balanced by control. A stint in English county cricket may further round his game and turn him into a pillar of our test batting lineup for years to come.
What Temba is to cricket, 16-year-old Sam Cele may very well be to surfing. Sam is the first Zulu female to compete in a world surf event, and this girl was born to ride.
Home to consistent quality waves, Durban has produced countless world-class surfers. The mold was reshaped when a 14-year-old summer killer, Siwe Cele, came to the attention of board manufacturer and internationally renowned big wave surfer, Jason Ribbink.
Hi, Sam. How are you?
Hello.
How
good are you?
So good to finally meet you.
It's great.
Hi, Jason.
Hi.
Now, we cover a lot of surfers, but you're a unique package. Where did your love for surfing come from?
I think it started when I loved aqua sports. Well, Jason here showed me where Sandile Mqati is, and he teaches surfing at the Shaga Beach. So I went there one weekend with my parents and my brother, and then we started surfing. From then, I kind of loved it.
Jason, I've met the surf kid. You must be the Mr. Miyagi of the story.
No, I wouldn't say that, but Sam's been a great inspiration to a lot of girl surfers, not just black girl surfers, but all girl surfers, because she started surfing in 2012, I think it was, and her first year of surfing, she actually saw her compete at the development games down in Port Elizabeth, And I could just tell something unique about Sam, that she wasn't going to give up. A lot of surfers, the initial stage of surfing is not really the fun stage. And she wasn't going to quit no matter what. So even though she wasn't catching a lot of waves back then, I could just see she's just always in the water no matter if it was good waves, bad waves. And I just really liked her attitude.
How did the two of you meet?
I'm friends with Sam's dad. And her dad said to me one day that I've got this daughter and son that really want to surf, but he didn't know enough about the sport. So I just directed him to the right place and just said, look, if they really want to surf, they'll be able to surf. And got them on some boards, and then, you know, like I say, the rest is history.
No surfers compete without their board. Is this Sam's board?
No, this is a stock board. We actually, today, we're going to customize Sam's board, and we're going to make it specifically for her needs and make it from scratch. And hopefully that's going to take her surfing to the next level. So let's go check it out. Let's go see the process.
Very cool. I can't wait.
Investing in Sam and her development is so rewarding because surfing is simply her everything. Shaping boards for her is a specific high-tech process. And with her skill level growing as fast as she is, her boards need to keep pace.
This is super cool. Is this essentially the Ferrari of surfboards?
Pretty much. This particular board is customized for Sam's exact height, her weight, and where she is in her surfing. And we've taken a lot of information from her previous board, and we've put it into a customized board for Sam. So we believe with this board, she's gonna just go from strength to strength.
So, well, I can't wait to see you out there in the waves.
One man who really enjoys that is her father, policeman Nkalipi Cele. When his conscientious daughter is not catching waves, she's studying or helping her mother with household errands, but always with an ear out for the surf report.
Would you say you're quite the adrenaline junkie?
Yeah, it's totally something else when you just go out there. I mean, it's amazing just to stand up on the board, like something magical.
You must feel quite free when you're out there.
I feel like I'm on top of the world and just doing that perfect turn. It's just super fun, it's amazing.
Sam's parents, Nkalipi and Nombali Trele, her friends, and even the Kwadukuza municipality have been very supportive.
You must be so proud of everything she's achieved. She's literally a role model to other young girls.
Yes, I'm very, very proud. As the Palito Pro, she was the first African girl to enter the international competition. I was very happy and proud, and I'm just encouraging her to go more with the sport, because it's a sport that she likes.
Sam's effort is paying off. At the SA Club Champs in Jeffreys Bay, her Sasonke Club came fifth. She hopes to represent Etek Queenie Surfing at the SA Open Champs this year and make the women's event at the Balito Pro in July.
You're officially the coolest surfer chick I know. How does it feel to know that you're inspiring other young girls?
Well, I want more Zulu girls to start surfing, to be introduced to these kind of things, because they can make a career out of these. They can earn a lot, and it's fun to do something that you love.
What's a big plan for Sam?
I want to be the world champion. I know it's something that's very far, but if I just focus and put my mind to it, I can do it.
You have a new cheerleader, and I know you're going to achieve all of that. So high five to that.
Thank you.
Love you, Sam.
Thanks.
Sam's earned that board through sheer determination. And with every wave she conquers, the belief of other young South Africans soars. Girls, guys, you could do it too.
Just ahead, Miss SA Liesl Laurie joins Chef Matt Manning to toast our champagne of fruit juices and cooking with apples.
Next, Miss South Africa 2015, Liesl Laurie, gets set to make her mark after her reign. She finds inspiration in toasting 50 years of a real South African classic with a fitting apple tribute cooked up by world-renowned chef Matt Manning.
With hot summers to mature the fruit and cold, wet winters for the trees to rest, Elgin is the capital of apples, known for their substance and their appearance. It's rather like another of our national treasures.
Crowning a special moment is much more magical when doing it with a friend, especially if she's the apple of South Africa's eye. Liesl Laurie.
Having made it into the top 10 at Miss World, last year, Liesl won the Continental Queen of Beauty Africa title.
So we know the story of Miss South Africa, but what was your journey like to Miss World?
So the journey to Miss World had a month of intensive training, and the reason why I chose that, yes, training, the reason I chose that was because Rolene, the previous year, came third in the sports challenge, and I wanted to come first. And even though I didn't, I managed to come seventh at Miss World. But for me, it was more about showing people about my country, teaching them that we are the country of love in Ubuntu.
You look absolutely beautiful at Miss World. Your outfit was exquisite.
I was wearing Casper Bosman. I was blessed that he made me 7 different dresses to wear across the journey of Miss World. So I was a very spoiled girl, and I got to show off a little bit of our African and South African prints in another country. And then what was special about my dress was it was called the African Goddess. And even though it had about 50 buttons going up the back, and it took me about a minute to get in and out of it every time, I was very excited to be on stage and showcase South Africa.
Your experience in China must have been an adventure, and I'm sure you picked up a couple of words along the way.
I learned how to say hello, which is ni hao.
Ni hao.
And xie xie, which is thank you.
Xie xie.
What I also learned was a little bit of Spanish, because I spent a lot of time with the Latina ladies, and I learned hola, which is hello. Como estas, which is how are you? And my favorite one, which is mi amor, which means my love, and that's what you get to call me from now on.
Vaminos, mi amore.
Ah, mi amor.
Hey, think quick.
In these orchards of Applethwaite Farm, we were walking through a proudly South African story. In 1966, apples from this farm went into the first release of Appletizer. But long before this global brand was established, its founder had a plan.
The legend goes that Edmond Lombardi made a fortune selling Italian marble in London, and then decided to relocate to South Africa and bought this beautiful farm and established his home here, which was built in the 1930s. Not satisfied with the beverages that were existing on the marketplace, he decided to go back to Europe and search for technology that could produce a champagne-like apple sparkling beverage. So the secret and the technological breakthrough that he came up with was to actually be able to capture and store the aromas from the different types of apple, namely the Granny Smith and, of course, the Golden Delicious.
Consistently a great drink for 50 years, what is Appletizer doing to celebrate the golden anniversary?
We are giving our consumers the opportunity to crown moments of their own. There are going to be lots of competitions and fun elements, the opportunity to surprise and delight them. We're giving away a trip to Royal Ascot. We sponsor Ascot in the UK, so we're giving our South African consumers the opportunity to win the trip of a lifetime there. And then at the end of the year, we're giving consumers the opportunity to win a trip to the Big Apple to crown their moment on New Year's Eve in Times Square.
As well as being the heart and soul of the beverage, Elgin's apples are the latest subject of Chef Matt Manning's famous style of cooking, where a series of dishes are based around one featured ingredient. He gave us a preview of the 6-course apple menu he'll be serving in Cape Town in March.
What exactly are we going to be using these apples for?
We're going to prepare a 2-course menu using the apples in each course, and basically incorporating other ingredients into the dish to highlight the apple flavor. And then pair it with a wine such as Lothian Vineyards or Appletizer.
I'm excited. Okay, how can we help?
Okay, so what we're gonna start with is the celeriac, and I'm going to get that peeled and prepared for you, Chris.
Yes.
And in the meantime, Liesl, you're gonna take the fennel and finely slice that on the mandolin.
Sure.
Okay, so can I leave you to do that?
You can leave me to do that.
Okay. She's a big girl.
That's you I'm worried about.
Oh.
So I'll peel the celeriac. And then you are going to chiffonade.
Chiffonade.
Yes.
Very interesting word for slicing.
Finely, finely sliced. And watch your fingers. Keep your thumb behind the 3 fingers in front.
Behind, like that.
Yeah, I want chiffonade, not chips, yeah, Chris.
Okay, wait. Maybe I don't have this as much as I thought.
Nah, I'd give him a 7 out of 10.
A 7 out of 10?
Wow! It wouldn't even make a rating.
Oh, no!
Hey, man, keep it green, stay lean, be friendly.
Shall I show you how it's done?
Yes, please.
Let the master do it.
This process releases the aroma.
So we're going to add those two together in the bowl. Bit of salt in there as well.
Right.
And our radishes, please, Liesl.
As well as cucumbers, is that correct?
Perfect.
There we go.
Mixing in creme fraiche and mayonnaise brings flavor and binds the ingredients. A tablespoon of whole grain mustard adds just enough spice.
So the flavour of the apple, the freshness, is just going to lift the whole dish. We're going to add that into there now. Bring that together, and then that's ready to go. All right, so now for the fish, we've got some yellowtail. Beautiful, sustainable fish. And all we need to do is a little bit of salt, a little bit of oil in the pan, and then you don't take any of that natural flavour from the fish away.
Let it lie in the pan and caramelise the one side.
How will we know when it's ready?
Well, I'm glad you asked, because a lot of people will make the mistake of asking how many minutes does it have to go in the pan. And you never cook by minutes. You cook by touch, feel, taste. You know, use your senses.
TFT.
TFT, that's a good way of remembering.
Add a little lemon. The stock from a dish of braised chicken wings makes the ideal sauce. Garnish and serve with that proudly South African apple juice.
I know that you've experienced and learned a lot as Miss South Africa. What advice do you have for those competing for your crown?
My advice is to the winner and also to the class of 2016 to always spread love and kindness no matter where they go, because people will always remember how you felt. And ultimately, it is up to us to show that South Africa is really the country of love and Ubuntu.
Apple Ties is celebrating their 50th anniversary. What do you see yourself achieving over the next 50 years?
I'd like to continue the legacy of the ripple effect, showing people that love and kindness ultimately is what the world needs. For me, it's also to have a happy and a beautiful family and to spread my love wherever I go. I know I have a light within me that was meant to shine and guide people wherever they go, and I intend to keep that light for the next 50 years, for the next 100 years if possible, and share it everywhere I go.
All right, guys, time for dessert.
That looks absolutely scrumptious.
Thank you very much.
Wow, what is it?
Well, we've got a pistachio and apple cake with a lemon curd mousse and pistachio crumb, all finished off with raspberries filled with a lemon curd mousse.
It looks delicious, and I can't wait to get in.
And we've also got a cheeky little mocktail that I prepared for you.
In the mix, lemon, ginger, mint, cucumber, and appetizer.
Taste that and tell me how it is.
Before we have a taste, I'd like to propose a toast and crown the moment to Liesl Laurie and the next Miss South Africa.
To the next Miss South Africa.
Cheers.
To Liesl, we have every faith you'll do great things. To that brilliant apple drink we love so much, here's to 50 more years of keeping us all refreshed.
Stay right there for the story of Monique Fleming, who turned a hair-raising problem with her husband's beard into a winning grooming brand.
Sometimes we overlook opportunities right under our nose, but not so for Monique Fleming. She could have seen her husband's unruly beard as a crisis, but this entrepreneur saw a business. It's this spirit, drive, and ingenuity that Standard Bank is committed to nurturing.
As the global trend with facial hair looks set to stay, timing couldn't be better for entrepreneur Monique Fleming to open her first male grooming outlet. With a varied background in marketing and hair extensions, she still had to recognize the moment.
Monique, what inspired you to do something so cool?
My husband Joe's beard was actually the inspiration. He started growing it about 2 years ago, and it got to the point where it was irritating him as much as it was irritating me. So I initially started making the products for very selfish reasons. I needed to find something that would treat his skin as well as soften his hair. So upon more investigation and more research, I realized that a lot of the guys overseas, like 99% of them, were actually handcrafting these products, you know, in their homes and their garages. And I thought, well, if they can do it, so can I.
Monique, you've done so incredibly well. How did you get your business off the ground?
So we first started selling our products at markets. The only hurdle I had was that our business was a month old and we had no form of accepting credit cards. So at the time I looked at various options, and the one that stood out for me the most was a product called SnapScan from Standard Bank. And I called them, and within 24 hours they were at the house, they signed me up in less than 20 minutes. It was a whirlwind experience, and the very next day I was at markets able to accept credit cards as well as cash. And it kind of evolved from there. From markets, we decided to move on to an online store, and from online store, we decided to move to retail.
Her first barber shop is an experience beyond the everyday.
Monique, I'm a little nervous about putting a razor to my face. What exactly are we going to be doing today?
So today, Morgan the barber is going to be doing a hot towel shave for you. So what that essentially means is Morgan's going to be applying a pre-shave oil. This will start to soften up your hair and skin. He'll then apply a hot towel, which will start softening up the hair and skin and opening up the pores. Once that has happened, he will remove the towel and apply a lather shaving soap. This is another step to soften your hair and skin and also help the blade glide over your face easier.
But Chris still needed some convincing.
I don't always have time to go to a professional barber, so what tools can I use to upkeep this look at home?
So we're going to send you home today with a range of bona fide products. Those will include beard balms, oils, cleansing bars, brushes, pre and post shaving oils, and you're in good hands because it's quite easy to do at home, and you know what? Your beard deserves it.
Monique started with just 1,300 Rand, made her products at home, and with herself and husband Joe active on social media, marketing took off. Standard Bank commend the couple on putting their profits back into the business.
Okay, take me through the steps of what's going on here.
What I do is I mix our key ingredients, which consist of beeswax and coconut oil. I add a very special blend of essential oils and carrier oils. We don't use any preservatives or chemicals in our products, so all the smells you're getting from our products come from all the natural ingredients that we put into the balm. Slow and steady wins the race.
Alright. Does it solidify or...?
It eventually solidifies once it reaches room temperature. But then it emulsifies again at body temperature. So the minute you rub it into the palm of your hand, it melts.
Not too bad, huh?
That's pretty perfect.
Hey, Joe, what's happening, man? What's good to see you again.
You too.
You must be Maddie. High five, buddy. You are Maddie, aren't you? You're a very busy woman. How do you balance your family life with your business?
Well, fortunately for us, because we run the business from home, it gives us the luxury of being business owners and parents at the same time. I also have a tremendous staff that are literally my left hand and my right hand, and together, teamwork makes the dream work.
Speaking of teamwork makes the dream work, Joe, I'm sure you really enjoy working with your wife.
I do. It's fun for us. We feed off each other. We know the end goal. It's a challenge, but we get through it and we do work well together.
Maddie, do you help your mom make the balm? Do you know anything about the business? Can you tell me about this bona fide beard oil? No, not really. Are you shy? You've made a success of both beards and your business. And you're probably South African. Do you mind if I try some of this at Sayo? You're gonna try some with me, buddy? Makes your beard grow.
It certainly helps having Standard Bank nurturing tomorrow's entrepreneurs today.
What a dynamic, diverse, talented, driven, smart, and charming group of young South Africans. They represent the best in us, and it's always such a privilege to bring you their stories. Until next Thursday, good night and God bless.
Next week, we ask Rolene Strauss about the only day that could ever top winning Miss World. Then, join us in the capital of alternative design for the latest riveting collections from London Fashion Week. Plus, take a look back at standout top billing homes.